This video is based on invasive weed optimization algorithm, and we will try to understand how this algorithm is working step by step with numerical example. Topics covered in this video: first, we have basic introduction about weed. What is this algorithm all about? Various steps involved in this algorithm, and then we will try to understand how each step is performed in this algorithm with numerical example. Meta-heuristic algorithms are divided into two categories: single-based and population-based meta-heuristic algorithm. Population-based meta-heuristic algorithms are further divided into different categories, as you can see here. Nature-inspired algorithms are further subdivided into different categories. Here you can see plant-based algorithm. Invasive weed optimization algorithm is a plant-based algorithm that is inspired by nature, and it is population-based meta-heuristic algorithm. Weed means unwanted plants or undesirable plants. For example, you can see here, they can adapt according to different environment and they can change their behavior and get fitter. We can easily find weed in park, field, garden and lawn. In any mature parent plant, seeds are formed when egg is fertilized by pollen. Then nature plays a very important role for the seed distribution. Then seed is distributed by wind, water, birds, insects or animals. When this seed finds out space for the growth, it will germinate if conditions are favorable. If conditions are not favorable, then it will die. So if conditions are good, after certain growth, it will turn into an adult plant. Then the next stage is seed production. It will turn into flowering plant. Invasive weed optimization algorithm is a population-based meta-heuristic algorithm, or we can say agriculture-based algorithm that is inspired by nature. And this algorithm is inspired from colonizing weeds, and we can use this algorithm to solve different real world optimization problems. Here we have certain steps followed in this algorithm. First, we have initialization phase. Here we will initialize all the important parameters required in this algorithm. Next, we will initialize the population. Here initial population is created by spreading finite number of seeds randomly in the search space. After that, we will compute the fitness value for the each seed. Here you can see seeds are randomly distributed. Then we will compute the fitness value for the each seed. Here you can see certain stages: seed, then young plant, mature plant, fruit and seed production. Every seed will grow into flowering plant and produce more seeds. That is the reproduction phase. After that, we will compute the best and the worst values among all, because seed production is based on fitness value. So we will compute the individual fitness value, best fitness value and the worst fitness value. After that, next step is determine new position of seed in the search space, that is random distribution of germinated seeds. Here, for the randomness and adaption, normally distributed random numbers are used, and seeds are normally distributed near to their parent plant, that we will see in the example how we can do that. Now we will try to understand how this algorithm is working step by step with numerical example. First step is initialize all the important parameters that are required in this algorithm. So first we have lower bound -10, upper bound 10, maximum of iteration I'm using here 5, population size, that is the initial population size is 4, and maximum population size is 10, minimum number of seeds 0, maximum number of seed 5. In next step, we will initialize the population. As you can see here, initial population is created by spreading finite number of seeds randomly in the search space. Now we will initialize the population randomly. You can see we initialize this population for the 4 seeds, as the initial population size is 4. So we have initial population. and you can see all the values are within the lower bound and upper bound. Now using a fitness function, we will compute the fitness value for the each seed. So put all these values in this function and we got initial fitness for each. After that, we will find out the best and the worst solution. Here best means minimum value, that is this one, and the worst means maximum value, that is this one. So here this is the best solution and this is the worst solution. This is the main loop or this algorithm. Here you can see this is nested for loop. So first, this is the stopping criteria. When this stopping criteria is matched, stop executing and display the value that you got. So when this stopping criteria is matched, display the result. Inside this loop, you can see first we will update the standard deviation, that is value for sigma. Then we will compute the value for the best, worst, that is required for the seeds. After that, we'll initialize the population, reproduction phase, and then inside this loop, you can see here, we will initialize the population, generate random location, compute fitness values, merge population, sort out, and find out the best solution. Let's see how we can perform all these steps. The next step is, here you can see here I'm here update standard deviation. Here maximum number of iteration is 5, so I put the value 5. Now we will update the standard deviation, that is this one. So compute the value for sigma. Maximum number of iteration, current iteration is 1, and initial value, final value, and we got value for sigma 0.32. Now get the best and the worst cost values, that is the best fitness value and the worst fitness value. Best is this one and worst is this one, as we computed before. Now here reproduction phase started. For I is 1 to 2, population size is 4. Compute ratio and value for S. As you can see, we require a value for S. So first we will compute the ratio, and ratio is individual fitness value minus worst fitness value divided by best fitness value minus worst fitness value. After that, S is equal to minimum seed plus maximum seed minus minimum seed into ratio. So put all these values. So here you can see, for the first individual, fitness value is 1.69, worst value is this one, best value is this one. Put all these values and we got ratio 0.9191, and then compute the value for S, that is this one, 5. Now J is 1 to 5. Now we are here inside this loop. Now we'll initialize offspring. So generate random location. Now we will compute the new solution, new position, new fitness values and all. So here J is 1 to 5. Initially value for I is 1, J is 1. And we can generate new location by using this equation. New solution position is individual position, this one, plus sigma value that we computed before into any random value. This is the normally distributed random value within the domain 0 and 1. So put the value here. Here you can see first position is 1.3 plus sigma is 0.32, and any random value you can choose. And then we got the new solution position 1.39. Now compute the fitness value for each. Okay, now we will compute the fitness value for the new solution. So use this fitness function, put the value here, and we got 1.93. As seed are germinated near to their parent, therefore you can see here J is 1 to 5. In we computed values for I equal to 1 and j equal to 1. Now value for I is 1 and j is 2, as the value for j is 1 to 5. Now I is 1, j is 2. As the seeds are distributed near to their parent plant. So individual position value is same, that is 1.3. Sigma value is same, 0.32. Change the random number value here and compute new position and new cost for this individual. And we got, you can see, 1.321 new solution position, and cost is this one. Here you can see we have a number of random numbers within 0 and 1 that I'm using for the calculation. Now I is 1, j is 3. So again we repeat, position for the first individual is same, value for the sigma is also same, change the random number value and we got new position, new solution. Now value for I is 1, j is 4. Values are same, just change the random value and we got this one. And again, I is now 1, j is now 5. So this is the last one. New position is this one and the cost is this one. After that, you can see this is nested for loop. Now end, we computed all the values 1 to 5. Now this loop completed. Now again, now value for I is 2, as we have values I 1 to 4, now value for I is 2. Put I equal to 2, compute ratio here. Second individual fitness value is 4, worst value, best minus worst, and we got this one. Put the value here. And we got 3.8, that is approximate 4. Now value for j is 1 to 4. So we will compute new 4 solution. Now here we are inside this loop. Again, compute new solution, position and the cost. Here we will put value for the second individual, that is this one, 2. Sigma is 0.32, any random value, and we got new solution this one and new cost this one. Now value for j is 2, I is 2. Put all these values and we got this. And now j is 3, j is 4, and here we got all these solutions, you can see here. Now again we will repeat. Now value for I is 3. So put I equal to 3, I 3 cost is 0.36, compute this and we got 5. So again we will compute new 5 solution, as j is equal to 1 to 5. So put value for the j is 1, j is 2. Here you can see we will put the value this one in the position and sigma and random value. J is equal to 3, j is 4. And j is 5, and we got new solutions. As now again we will repeat this loop. Now value for I is 4, as we have I is 1 to 4. Now value for I is 4, put fourth value here, that is 16.81, and compute this and we got 0. This time we will compute only one solution, and this is j is 1 to 0. So compute value and put the value here. For the fourth solution we have 4.1 and random value sigma is same, and we got this. As you can see we got all these solution here. Now next step, now we will exit this loop. As now next here, merge population. Now we will merge the population, it means initial population and the all new solution that we computed. Merge all this, as you can see, 1 to 19. Now sort population. Now we will sort all these values according to their fitness value. So check the fitness value for the eating individuals, and we will sort from minimum to maximum. Sort order is 3, 15, 14, 18. Minimum value is 3. After this one 15, next is 14, then 18. So according to their fitness value, we will sort from minimum to maximum. So this is the sort order that we got. You can cross check this. Now next step is compete. In the colonies, neighbor plants compete with each other according to their age, size and distance apart. So they interfere in each other activities. So any plant birth, growth, reproduction is influenced by density, population, fitness of the plant, how fit it is for the survival. So same step we will perform now. So how we will perform this? We will check whether the merged population is greater than maximum population size or not. If the merged population size is greater than the maximum population size, then we will consider the population from 1 to maximum population size. And the maximum population size is 10. So put all this value. Merged population, we have 19, all values. And here, maximum population size, we set is 10. So this condition is true. So now we will consider the population from 1 to 10. And so that's how we performed competition in this algorithm. So all the other values are the birth values, so we will not consider, and they are the plant, they died spores. Now we have 10 values. After that, next step is sort out the best solution and display the result. So here the best solution found means, best solution means solution at the first position is the fittest solution that has the minimum fitness value. So this is the best solution found, and for the first iteration we have best solution 0.36. Now again we will repeat this loop until stopping criteria is matched, that is 1 to 5. So 5 times we will repeat this loop. This is performed for the first iteration, we got this solution. Like that, we will compute for the second, third, fourth, and fifth. And after that, we will display the final result. So next, for the second iteration, we will again repeat this loop, all these steps, and then display the best solution found. So that's all about this video. If you have any question, you can comment below. And thanks for watching this video.